class. Today we're going to talk about the different types of number sets, and it's nice to know what kind of numbers exist and which ones are appropriate for different types of answers. For instance, you might get an answer to a problem that doesn't make sense and you have to change it into a different kind of number for it to make sense. For instance, there's a statistic that there are approximately 2.6 children per family, but it doesn't make sense to have a 0.6 child, so it would make more sense to say that there are two or three children for most average American families instead. So we need to know what kind of numbers we have. We're going to take a look at the most basic type of number, which is the natural number. And the natural numbers are numbers that you would normally use to count different items. So these are often called counting numbers. And that's because if you were to pick up a bag of oranges or something and count how many are in it, you would start naturally with the number 1, then count 2 and 3, and so on until you get how many items are in the bag. And so natural numbers are the numbers that you would naturally count with. Now, when you build upon that number set, you get to the number set that also includes the idea that if you have a bag, it could have items in it that you could count, or it could be empty. And if it's empty, you add on the idea of having the number 0, and that gives us these whole numbers here. So those are 0 plus the counting numbers. So those would be numbers like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Now, once we get past the whole numbers, we add on the idea that not only could you have a bag with items in it, or a bag that's empty, you could also owe somebody something. And if you could either have oranges, have no oranges, or owe somebody oranges if you were counting oranges, for instance. And when you get to that, you get into the idea of the integers. The integers are the numbers that most people label on a number line. If you make a number line, you normally draw something like this, and most people will put 0 somewhere right here, and going the direction you read, you would get larger and you'd put the positive counting numbers. And you would continue on as far as you needed to. And then going the other direction on the number line are all the negative numbers. And so normally the numbers we label on those would be the negative counting numbers. And those will start with negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and so on. So we get into the idea of over here that you could owe somebody items. Here you could have no items, and over here you could have items. And these numbers that I labeled on the number line are what we call the integers. There are numbers in between all these numbers that we put on the number line here, and those numbers are fractions of whole amounts, so like a half or 1.5 or 2.3 and so on. When we get into the idea of having numbers in between all these, we get into the idea of a rational number. A rational number is anything that can be turned into a fraction. So that would be numbers like the number 2. You could put that as 2 over 1, so that is a fraction. Something like 2/5 is a fraction. Something like square root of 9 is actually a fraction, because square root of 9 is 3, and 3 could be written as 3 over 1. Something like 0.25, that's a decimal that ends. Any decimal that ends can be transferred into a fraction. For instance, 0.25 is the same thing as 1/4. Also, any decimal that repeats, like 0.3 going on forever, that's actually 1/3. Another way to write 0.3 repeated is, instead of to have a few of them there with dots on the end, we could put a bar over the top, and that means that the 3 repeats forever. Any decimal that ends or any decimal that repeats, so for instance, something like 19 with a bar would mean that that decimal is 0.191919 forever. So any decimal that ends, any decimal that repeats, anything that obviously is written like a fraction, or anything that you could put over 1 is also a rational number. And you can have positive and negative numbers for rational numbers. Now that brings us to irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are things that are not fractions. So, for instance, the most popular one that people are aware of is the number pi. We approximate pi as 3.14, but it's actually a decimal that goes on forever and it never repeats. And because of that, it's actually not a fraction. Another number would be like square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 5. Notice that I skipped square root of 4 because square root of 4 is 2, and 2 is up here as one of our fractions. So basically the square root of any number that's not a perfect square, because you can't turn it into a whole number. Also, there's a number called e, which is approximately 2.718. But just like pi, it's a number that goes on forever and never repeats. It's one that you use quite a bit when you're talking about logarithms, which is in a later class. So these are the different number sets that we have here. And all of these numbers that you see here are what we call real numbers. So everything you see here is a real number. Now you may have problems that ask you what number sets does this particular number belong to. For instance, if it gives you the number 2, the number 2 is a natural number. It's also a whole number. It's also an integer. It's also a rational number, and it is a real number. So you would list all of those different types of numbers for what the number 2 is. If you were given the number 2/3, 2/3 is a rational number, and it's also a real number. But it is not any of the other number sets, so you would only give those two values. If you were given the number -5, -5 is an integer. It's also a rational number, and it's a real number, so you would list all of those. And those are the different types of number sets. Those will help you in deciding if the type of answer you're getting makes sense for your situation.